Today on the Freemason Report, 10 ways to get your fraternity to grow its brand in your local community. Today on the Freemason Report, we're going to look at 10 ways you can get your fraternity to grow its brand in your local community. As you know, there's a lot of different ways you can grow your brand in the community. I'm going to share top 10 ways that I think you can instantaneously grow your footprint in your community so more people are aware that the community has a Freemason Lodge in it. Here is the first item that you can do. Set up a Google My Business page for your fraternity so someone can find you online. And if they're looking up Freemasonry, Freemasons, Masonic, a local fraternity, local Freemason Lodge, your Freemason Lodge will pop up on the Google map, which goes a long way. Now, I know some of these can be really quick and simple, but the purpose of it is just to help you sort of do things that will make a difference to grow your lodge. Second thing that you can do, so I just sort of started off with saying, let's have a Google My Business page. Set up a website. That's right. Set up a website for your lodge. Make sure it covers who the offices are, a welcome message, an about us page, sort of giving the history of how long it's been in the community, and have a charitable works page, like what charitable activities are you doing to help support the community. And of course, you want to make sure that on your lodge website, you have your dinner meeting times and location and street address, telephone number if someone wants to call you, email address if someone wants to reach out and email you if they're interested in joining the lodge. Third thing you can do to increase this footprint of your Freemason Lodge, if you're not already contributing to charitable efforts, have your Freemason Lodge pick 3 or 5 different charitable endeavors that you can contribute to. It could be Habitat for Humanity, it could be a food bank, it could be helping dogs and cats that are strays that need to get adopted. It could be contributing to local schools for school supplies. There are endless things that you can do. Just pick a few and say, this is what we're going to do this year to help support our community. Another thing that you can do to help make a difference in your community and to get engaged and let people know that you're aware, set aside a telephone number and email address strictly for the Blue Lodge. So this way, someone reaches out and contacts your Blue Lodge, you have one email address, one telephone number that could be used for numerous years, not the leadership in place where you have their cell phone numbers out there and then they step off a leadership role and they become more of a brother again, or they get involved in a different organization. You want to have a telephone number that's strictly for your Blue Lodge. You can pick one up at Magic Jack. You can pick one up at Google Voice. Google Voice is actually free. You can get one from a cell phone company. You just have a cell phone. You can get a landline. Some actual internet companies actually supply you with a telephone number as a bundled package deal. So take advantage of that. Plus, you want to have an email address. I would recommend if you're going to set up a website, set up an email address, get the SSL certificate, tie it together so you have info@yourlodge.com name, or you can have it at learnmore@whatever email address you want to use. Now, if you don't want to go the route of actually having to have a lodge website, and you don't want to have a branded lodge domain name, just get your Gmail account, Yahoo account, and get that for free and have people check it out there. There's Hotmail, there's a bunch of different ones that are available. You can even go old school and kick it with the AOL account. Whatever you think is best, I recommend you consider trying that out. But make sure that you do get an email address. So if one secretary or one lodge officer resigns, another one comes in, they can have a history of communications happened on behalf of the lodge digitally. You want to set up Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, you want to set up Tumblr, you want to set up Reddit, you want to set up whatever you think is a good fit for your local area. If you know a lot of people are taking advantage of Snapchat or they're taking advantage of Instagram, set up an Instagram or a Snapchat account. It's not hard to do. You just have to have someone dedicated to posting new stuff and keeping up with it. And again, if you have your own lodge email address, you put the lodge email address in charge of those accounts and you never lose control of them. You never have to worry about if someone passes away, moves away, or just drops out of the fraternity for whatever reason, for not being able to pay dues maybe, and now you're up a creek without a paddle. So you want to take control of that. Now, I know I'm tossing a lot of different things out at you, but this is all really to make your life and your fraternity actually more well-rounded and to get your name out there. And the more you get your name out there, the better you're going to help your fraternity help the community. So what is another idea that you can do? I recommend having lodge polo shirts. Lodge button-down shirts. Put the square and compass with your lodge name on it, with the city or county or area that you're in, so people know, oh wow, Freemasons are here and they're alive and well. Then walk around the community and actually wear the shirts, not at the lodge meeting, but in the community on a regular basis. That will get the word out there that you're alive and well. Another idea is make lodge hats. Put something on your head. There's a lot of different styles of hats out there. Hats are really kind of enjoyable and relaxing to wear. You can have one that's maybe for biking, walking, hiking, just walking around the community, hanging out. You can get one for poolside. Have the square and compass on there with your lodge name and the city and state that you're in. What's another way you can communicate that the lodge is alive and well in the community? My recommendation is something I tried to do during my year as Worshipful Master, and it didn't come together as I hoped it would, but I wanted to give pencils with the lodge website address to every new student going to school for that year. We just couldn't get the logistics down in time, but this is an amazing idea because how many kids are at your local elementary school? How many kids are at your local high school? How many kids are at your local middle school? If you give every one of those students one pencil with support from .com of the local lodge, now all those parents are saying, oh, let me check out that website. Now the kids are saying, like, hey, look at this. They lose them, they share them, they get out in the community, and they say, wow, the local Freemason Lodge is handing out pencils at the first day of school to all the kids in the school. It costs a few dollars, so you have the few dollars to toss at it. It's a really cool idea. And again, you have to get the logistics down just in time because you need to have those go out on the first day of school. What else can you do to actually get more engaged in the community and let people be aware? You can join the Chamber of Commerce. I know it's a big one, and I know the Chamber of Commerce is a business entity, but the purpose of the Chamber of Commerce is to let everyone in the community know what businesses are alive and well in the community. So by getting a chamber membership and spending that few hundred dollars a year on it, now you're connecting with other business professionals that have budget to actually spend on getting their name out there. And those are the people that we might want to pull into the fraternity and their employees and their family members. So even if it's not the president of the company, because some people might be offended, oh my gosh, you're only targeting the presidents. No, I'm talking about every member of that company is a good possible person to talk about Freemasonry to, because they do have the money set aside to budget for doing things like that. So being part of the Chamber of Commerce is a great way to get the conversation started with people. And even if they don't want to join our fraternity, that's fine. Now they have a good impression upon our fraternity to carry to other people that may be interested in our fraternity. What's another way that you can get connected to the community? Well, you know, you can buy bricks. I know every once in a while you might see around a community like gardens and different walkways where people can buy a brick and have it engraved with the name of their company, their family, maybe the lodge fraternity, to have put in there forever for people to see. This is a great way for someone that's in the community, community park, community building, wherever it might be, to say, hey, the Freemasons are alive and well. Look, they bought a brick. And that brick will outlast you during your term and might be available to see for 20, 30, 50 years down the road. Now, I've known I've tossed a lot out there for you, but I have plenty more that you can take advantage of. What's another thing that you can do? Well, obviously you can make lodge business cards, and you can leave business cards out at your lodge. You can have your brothers take a handful of the business cards. On the business cards, you can have the address, telephone number, email address, date, time, meeting, locations, when you start having dinner, to hand out to people to say, I'm part of this Freemason Lodge, please take one and be my guest. Great part about that business card, you can put it on the back, free dinner for a first-time visitor. You could do something fun like that, so it makes someone feel welcomed. And if they may not be able to join and they might be down on their luck, they can have a free dinner, and it shows that Freemasons really do care about people in the community. Also, on top of that, now you don't have to worry about a square and compass being put onto someone's business card that's meant for their business, but it goes for a actual branded piece of material that's only for the lodge. What's another thing that you can do to help grow your fraternity's presence in the community? Make some trifolds and bifolds brochures and have them to hand out when you're at special events that actually are detailed right down to your lodge level. I think the Scottish Rite is doing something like that. You might want to check out the Scottish Rite and see if you have ability to maybe get some stuff from them. I'm not 100% certain. I think in the past they did have that. So check and see if that is something that is available for you to take advantage of. So what is another thing that you can do? Well, you can make pens. You can make large pens, and you can have the pens, and you can hand them out around the community. When people come to the 4th of July parade, you can hand out pens there. When people come to like special events for the city, maybe the National Night Out, where you honor a local hero in the community, you can have pens to hand out there. The great part about pens, people take the pens and they share them with friends. Sometimes they get lost, some of the people get to use them. So you don't know where that pen's gonna end up, and it might end up in a hand of someone that might be interested in Freemasonry and say, hey, I wanna go check them out. So pens are really good. You could buy them in groups of 1,000, have all the brothers take 5 or 20 of them to have to use and hand out where they feel they need to. That's another really good idea. And the hits keep on coming. I think I may have actually crossed over 10, but if I did, that's okay. I think I've lost count, but it's no big deal. What's another thing that you can do to get your Freemason Lodge out in the community? You can make bumper stickers, and you can hand out bumper stickers to all the Lodge brothers to put on their cars to say, I'm proud to be a Freemason of Lodge X, Y, and Z. Great opportunity to get your name out there in the community. And the square and compass is on a brother's car. It's not going to anyone's car. It's going on to a brother of the lodge's car. What are some other things you can do to actually get your lodge name out there in the community? One thing that you can take advantage of doing is you can actually make a banner to put up on the Little League fence, and you can sponsor the Little League and give them a few $100 to support them. And then all year long, they see the square and compass, your lodge name, your lodge address, and someone that's in the stands at one of those games where they get 50 to 100 people, 200 people to show up. Maybe one person's like, I'm a Freemason, I'm so proud that they're doing that. Or maybe there's someone that says, I wanna be a Freemason, how do I get involved? Now you have it right out there in the field. So with that being said, those are some ideas. Those are some ideas. I hope you take advantage of one or two of them. But before I go, I have one other really cool idea I want to share with you to get your name in the community to help you grow your lodge presence. I want you to support the local PTA and teachers at the school. Buy the teachers lunch or breakfast and honor them for teaching all the youth in the community. Go to the PTA and make a sizable contribution, maybe $200 to $500 for their efforts. So the families, the 20% of the elementary school, high school, middle school that are super engaged and super involved say, man, Freemasons may be something I need to take a look at. And if you get the active 20% of that school engaged, now we have the active 20% that possibly you're gonna be very active in Freemasonry in the future. And it goes hand in hand. So if even if it's a woman and it's not someone that's a man, maybe they'll get involved and have their child join one of their youth organizations. Maybe they'll join the Eastern Star. So there's a lot of benefits that can come from it. And then we just have a great relationship with the local school system. So that's it. Be safe, stay happy, and remember, we're available on Patreon, so if you have an idea you want me to share, you want me to hit up, become a contributor, help me out so I can make some more videos and answer some of the questions that you may have. With that being said, stay safe, stay happy, stay healthy, and enjoy the fraternity.